Finally here on Most Buffalo, you know, I'm just a visitor here. Normally I'm a daybreaker, which means a couple of things. One, right about now is my nap time, and two, I need my coffee, and lots of it. The faster I can get it, the better. Huge cup first thing in the morning, and then about a dozen after that. Well, it was a local woman's need for caffeine and convenience that sparked the idea for Springville's newest coffee stop.
Anything that's quick as a mom, you know, is not actually quick. There's negotiations, there's buckling, there's zippers. Then you gotta go in, you got everybody holding hands, you gotta sit still, you know, don't be too loud, don't bother them, keep your mask on, quit chewing on it.
Parents, sound familiar? A quick stop turns into a bit of an ordeal, and maybe you wished you had something just a little bit stronger than a coffee. Well, that's one of the many reasons Elizabeth Andrews opened up her very first business. Welcome to the Sleeping Lady on West Main Street in Springville. Think of it as the tiny house version of a coffee shop.
9 times out of 10, people go, oh, we thought this was a watershed for the town. And it's like, oh, surprise, for coffee.
The baristas inside of this 10 by 16 foot space are cranking out hot, handcrafted beverages while you wait in your car.
I put your order in. A lot of the time, they already have it ready because they recognize the vehicle. And it's that short, quick interaction that still leaves an impression on somebody. This business model is very popular up in Alaska and Pacific Northwest in general.
She, her husband, and kids used to live in Alaska, but relocated to Springville to be closer to family. She had the idea for a grab-and-go coffee shop for quite some time now.
We joked about this right after we got down here, because what we were looking for wasn't in the area. So it was something we talked about, joked about, pushed around, and then all of a sudden, probably in August, we just started moving forward.
They started building in late summer and just opened 3 weeks ago. The name, The Sleeping Lady, is a nod to their time living in the last frontier.
It's Mount Susitna that you can see from downtown Anchorage. And it just kind of seemed right to be bringing a business model from Alaska to name it from something in Alaska too. And it was just kind of a play on sleep, coffee, the whole thing.
Being able to start a brand new business, hire 6 people, and seeing success during a pandemic isn't lost on her.
I am truly, truly blessed, and it really is the support of the community here that's making this happen. It hurts my heart seeing some of the businesses and the situations there are not being able to be open, or the restrictions that are put onto them, and they're doing everything they can to make ends meet. And I personally would love to find ways to partner with other small businesses in the area to make a difference for them and for us. I think that that's really the only way we're going to make it through this is by working together and leaning on each other.
That does it for us here on Most Buffalo. Thanks for watching. Happy Friday. Have a great weekend. Most Buffalo is back next week. Channel 2 News, first at 5, coming up next.